We have migrants and refugees coming from several countries, Afghanistan, Pakistan, the Palestinian territories. As an organization, we have decided to start working and supporting undocumented migrants in Greece.
Me, 4 months I stay in here.
4 months! Iraqi 4 months!
4 months, and after
Six
4 months, deport.
There are many needs that are uncovered, and mainly psychosocial needs. In most of the detention centers, there are no psychologists or social workers.
I need asylum in all world, because me, a Christian, you understand? Maybe in, come back in Iraq, kill me, somebody people.
We are treating migrants that have come in little boats to one of the Greek islands or have passed the Turkish-Greek border in the north of the country.
They're looking to have someone acknowledge that they're here and that they have needs and that they're human. That's the first thing, and that they want human contact as opposed to being treated as prisoners or, as they say, animals.
All people here, he need life, he need freedom.
They basically want a good future for their children, which they don't see in their own country.
I come from Afghanistan to Pakistan. From Pakistan, I speak to one smuggler. The smuggler says, I'll take you to one safe country. With daytimes, we sleep in, and the nighttime, we walk by food. And many hours, every night, like 5-6 hours walk.
It can happen that some of the members of the group they're traveling with die during their journey.
And other people, they live in the border between Iran and Turkey. They're from there, get the migrant and they stay, keep it there. And they say, give me your number from any country. So when they give the number and after call, this family says, put that much money from any country you have put in this account, their bank. Like this happening with everybody there. And if he's don't have money, if he's don't put it, they cut fingers, they cut his nose, they cut his hair.
When these people arrive in Greece, they usually, most of the times, they're arrested and they're kept in detention centers for a period that, according to the law, might be up to 6 months.
Wallah problem, here problem. Wallah problem, wallah.
They're coming from an already difficult situation, and they come to Europe with the expectation that it's going to be paradise and it's going to be a utopic environment, and then they're pretty much from the day that they arrive, they're thrown behind bars and they become disillusioned.
There's in one rooms they put about 80-85 people, and in one bathroom and one there for showers. And is this for the maybe, I don't know, maybe for the 5 months, 6 months, maybe they didn't wash the blankie, didn't change his clothes and change the pillow and to lie and everything.
When the migrants leave the detention centers, they are given a paper in which that it says that they have to leave the country within 30 days.
They don't care about where you're going, where you're sleeping, where you're eating, what do you want to do for you, medicines, for clothes, for everything. They don't care about it and give the paper for 1 month and say you go then.
Most of them stay in Athens. There is nothing for them. There is no housing, there is no work. They have no access to healthcare. Obviously, as a medical organization, we are very concerned about that.
Because so many migrants now I see is people don't have place and don't have to get food. Many people sleep in the street, sleep in the park.
My mother immigrated from Greece to Canada, my father from Germany to Canada, and I decided to come back. And whenever I see these people, I always think of my parents, and I see my parents in their eyes.
The majority of them doesn't really have a choice to stay in their countries, and we know that if they had the chance, of course, they would prefer to stay with their families.
Nobody, without any reasons, not leave his country, not leave his mother, father's wife and children. Of course, all the times I miss, and the day and the night times, I miss them.